Kagita, I want to ask you on that, because writers like yourselves, or people who in a sense reach out, have a vast audience of young people, why is it that there is a large segment of India which seems almost invisible? And you know, I notice this also when we have discussions, that somehow people want to say that we don't want to hear about this hunger, we don't want to hear about the fact that digital education isn't about online classes, but the number of children who can't afford even a simple cell phone to do those classes. So again, we seem to be back in this dichotomy that we heard of years ago with India Shining, where we still believe that somehow that it undercuts India, or you're less of a patriot if you admit that there are problems that a large segment of fellow Indians are facing.
Listen, I mean, there are problems. And if you ask me personally, I would rather have the economy grow a lot faster, a lot of changes happen. But I think as a writer who observes India, what I see is there is a certain contentment. I mean, our per capita incomes have risen from the late 1980s, 90s of $300 per person to 2000, which means Indians are not, abject poverty is not there as much. Even when you saw the migrant labor walk, they were wearing proper clothes and they had, I'm not saying they were not suffering, but people are not, there is still hunger, but the levels are much lower than before. So this is not just a case of a government doing it. It's a very popular government doing it. We keep forgetting when we call it undemocratic, it's not even a case like the Commonwealth Games camp when the Congress government had become unpopular. And Yogendra ji himself was at the forefront of those protests. And even they were doing, they were an elected government and they decided what laws to pass and what didn't. And they were protests. So, but that time there was a lot of unpopularity that government faced. This government is popular. They won twice, better the next time. And they, all surveys show that they're very popular. So people are not, can you imagine for example, even in the farmer bills, if it is so bad for farmers, which are 60% of the population is getting employed there, why would the government take such a suicide pill? You know, a section may be unhappy, but everybody would agree that the BJP knows how to win elections and they have very good political sense. Even their critics would agree. So why would they do it? Because they do, I think deep down, they know there is support for this. They know that they'll be able to get past it. Or maybe they know that there is no opposition. Maybe that's also a factor.
So you're saying why would any elected government take a suicidal step of actually angering a major chunk of the vote bank? But I just one point I want to
I think the vote bank is happy. People are happy.